You're watching Fox 4 News at 9 a.m.
The resident dog here at Bridge Space, KC.
This place is packed.
Yes, it is. We have so many people here, and we get people coming each show, and they're seeing how much fun we're having. I think they just can't help themselves. It's so much fun.
Hey, Steve Serrano's spinning the tunes. If we can bring that down just a little bit. Thank you very much. We have so much. I have sensory overload.
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah.
We have a lot of visuals, a lot of sound, and a lot of taste here today. In fact, one of the most famous, if not the most famous, cinnamon rolls ever made are from Neighborhood Cafe, and they brought another platter here.
Thank you.
Now, when you go to Neighborhood Cafe, they serve these on the table. My recommendation, though, the little hack, ask them to heat it up. Just 5 seconds in the microwave is really
good. I can't imagine,
because
these are so good cold.
But I have been like, all these sweets, I've got to have some protein. Is there any protein in the house?
Oh, how about this?
Look what Tony has brought in for Mark Alford. Oh, no, you can't have that. Would you like some?
Oh.
Can she have a little bit?
Can
she have a little bit?
He can.
Yeah.
There you go. Aww. All right. Good boy.
This is delicious. Okay. So Lee's Summit has a lot of cool stuff to do, a lot of great food to eat. Here's a little bit more about Lee's Summit.
Lee's Summit, Missouri is about 30 minutes southeast of Kansas City. It's the sixth largest city by land area in the state. Population has more than doubled in the past 30 years, but ask any one of the 98,000 residents, it still has a small town vibe.
Everywhere you go, it has like the family feel. So it's great.
It's a great place to raise kids, a great place for a family.
From world-class schools, our amazing parks and rec system, and just that overall big city amenities with a small town feel.
Lee Summit was founded in the late 1800s by William B. Howard.
He came here in 1844 to establish the city. But before he did that, he was smart enough to know that the railroad was eventually going to come through here.
The railroad played a big role in how Lee Summit got its name. The summit half came from being the highest elevation along the railroad between Kansas City and St. Louis. The Lee part, well, it's still a debate.
Most of us historians believe that's actually named after Dr. Pleasant, L-E-A, and not after Robert E. Lee, like a lot of people want to believe. When the surveyors came from the railroad, they called this Dr. Lee's Prairie, but they didn't know that his name was L-E-A. So when they established their office, they wrote Lee's Summit on the boxcar, but they spelled it L-E-E-S.
In 1885, a devastating fire destroyed the commercial district downtown, but it didn't take long for the community to come together and rebuild. In fact, many of those buildings are still standing today.
Well, the downtown certainly is the heart of Lee's Summit. Things change, buildings change, and they've really put their heart into making downtown Lee's Summit part of the overall community.
Whether you're looking for a new place to eat, somewhere to take the kiddos, or a day of fun outdoors, give Lee's Summit a try.
You can, believe me, spend all day, all week, and just never leave. There's so much to love about Lee's Summit.
I love it. I mean, I love the people.
Just a tremendous place to be with a great attitude.
It is really a cool town.
It's a beautiful city. Unfortunately, today, well, this morning, not really the morning to get out and explore Lee's Summit. So we brought Lee's Summit to Bridge Space, KC, so it's nice and warm in here. Carly, when's it going to warm up? It's got to happen.
Happened this morning, unfortunately, guys. We are still pretty cold outside. In fact, most of us this morning have dipped into the upper 30s with wind chills in the upper 20s to low 30s. Everybody feels like it's below freezing. So we are cold. However, we're about to get back into some sunshine. Not necessarily just yet in Lee's Summit, but close. As these clouds depart off to the east, we will have more sunshine and 47 this afternoon. So not the warmest today, but things will get warmer. And we'll tell you when coming up.
I'm going to have a hard time hearing.
Hey, thank you very much, Carly. Lee Summit's filled with so many businesses. A lot of new businesses are coming in. And there's some older buildings here. A lot of the town has the older buildings, and new stores are moving into them.
Right, like Rachel Rourke's store.
Hi, good
so
to see you.
So you just opened up a store down the street from here.
We did.
What's it called?
L&M Boutique.
And what do you sell?
We sell women's clothing, shoes, gifts.
All the dangerous stuff.
All the dangerous stuff.
Okay, and tell me about the remodeling process. When you guys were getting set up in your store, you were doing a little reconstruction.
We did. The building that we have our store in, it was actually originally the Lee Summit Hospital back in the early 1900s.
Wow.
So we wanted to keep a lot of the original features, the wood floors, the brick walls, and my family was doing some remodeling of the space, getting it to look like a boutique, and underneath the floor we found a medicine bottle right here.
Oh, wow.
And that was made from 1900 to 1910.
Who's got a close up of
this? That's so cool.
Right.
An old medicine bottle. What was in here?
Yeah,
it was, it was created by Penslar Chemical Company. And after a little bit of research, we found that it helped with kidney health and urinary tract infections.
Interesting.
But the interesting tidbit is it's 18% alcohol.
Hey!
Wow.
That helped with
a lot of things.
I think
your rheumatiz.
Wow.
Everything back in the day.
So what's
except
it
for
like,
liver problems, probably.
You grew up in Lee Summit. You
yes.
moved away for a little bit.
I did.
Came back. What is the Lee Summit now like compared to the Lee Summit you left?
Very different. Very vibrant. You know, even growing up in Lee Summit, downtown really was a pass-through. You know, there were a couple of businesses there that you'd go specifically to, you know, shop at, but it wasn't a place to come and stay or walk around or spend your day. And coming back and being in downtown a little bit, I just wanted to be part of it.
Cool.
And so it was the perfect place to take on the new venture of starting my own business and really hopefully serving the community that raised me.
Well, good luck in your store. It
Thank
takes a
you.
Lot of guts to open your own store.
Yes.
Especially,
well,
you know, with the online sales right now to open a brick and mortar. I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Once again, the name of it is?
L&M Boutique.
So go there and check it out, all right?
That's right. All right, coming up next, we've got some really cool classes that you can take right here in downtown Lee Summit.
Also, the sounds behind us, Steve Serrano from Mix 93.3. He grew up right here in Lee Summit. We're going to talk to him a little bit. Stay with us, our zip trip.
Bruises.
Live in St. Michael's Drumline. Yes, they're up against the wall here in the bridge space, an old post office. And they welcomed Kathy Quinn as she came in off the Amtrak
from
Kansas City. They were there to welcome her to Lee Summit. And we have a special guest with us, Steve Serrano. He's been in our studio quite a bit, Mix 93.3. You grew up here in Lee Summit.
I did. I grew up in Lee Summit, so it's fun to be back in Lee Summit, especially when you do things like this.
You are killing it on spinning the tunes. We are having a great time this morning because of your music.
It's all based on the people. I can play the same music no matter where you go. It's based on the people that are there.
You have some older people in here. Are you playing some older tunes?
Oh, yeah. We played some Lean On.
We did.
We're all over the place for you.
It's fun to come back to your hometown and see people that influenced your life.
It's true. It's very cool because, you know, growing up in school, and you know, I really wanted to get into the radio and the TV side of things, and it was cool to even go back and talk to some of the kids that are still following that same path, and it's fun to really give back and to go from there.
And you also have a thriving DJ business. You're not just on the radio.
I try to be all over the place.
Yeah.
You never know. You never know from the Chiefs events to you know, house parties to DJing. You got to be all over the place. It's
weddings,
fun.
Bar mitzvahs.
That's right. Anywhere you need me to be. We can go to your house and we'll DJ tonight if you want.
Yeah, come on. Hey, Steve, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Coming up next, You know who Matt Chatfield is?
No.
He's the really tall chef that comes in our studio
and cooks with
Carly.
Yeah, he's like really tall and really a great chef.
So we're going to have to stand on our tippy toes.
Yeah.
Well, I gave it up. When Abby joined me 2 years ago, I thought, I'm going to stand on a box and I'm going to try to be her height. Well, I just gave up on that.
Well,
it's never going to happen.
Yeah.
So.
And I'm never going to be short.
Yeah.
So it's all good. That's just how that works.
We are who we are.
We know, Carly, that you cook with Matt all the time. This is a really cool place in downtown Lee's Summit. It's called A Time for Everything. And you can get a bunch of kitchenware. You can get spices. And here in the back, they do cooking demo classes. And Carly, you've been a part of that with Matt. What are we cooking up today, Matt?
So we're doing some steak street tacos with salsa verde. And we've got some steak on the grill right now, finishing up. Salt, pepper, garlic, lime juice, searing them off. You can use skirt steak too. And from there, we're building some street tacos on some corn tortillas. We want to double up the corn tortillas so they don't fall apart on us. So the ladies are assembling some of the grilled steak now with some Mexican crema.
Yeah, we recruited Kelly and Candace from the Neighborhood Cafe and Whistle Stop Cafe because they were following me around all morning, and I said, you know, if you're going to follow, we might as well put you to work. And so we're putting them to work. How much fun is it for you to teach these classes here for people who come in who might not know how to cook very well?
You know what? It's a blast. It's such a gift to pass on just little gems of stories, of recipes that might not be secrets, but those little gems you've learned over the years that you like to pass on. Tell the stories about your travels and about all the different fun techniques or little ingredients you've come up with over the years. And they say you don't start learning till you start teaching. And I'll tell you, it's just a treat to be able to teach people in this environment. And Lee Summit, this is a great little hidden gem in the middle of Lee Summit. A wide variety of chefs from around the area teach here and share their gifts. And you never leave hungry from the classes here. I can promise you. You're always well fed and
all right, let's try it.
Have a blast.
Candace, these two ladies cook at their own restaurant, so this better be good because we've got three chefs here making this. And I know Kathy from the Lee Summit Museum. Go ahead and try yours too. Wow.
We did good.
So good.
Really good.
Tell me about the cooking classes.
So the cooking classes, so Carly and I have one coming up in a couple of Saturdays, the 26th, I believe, Saturday. We're doing some different Mexican fare that you might not have had before, and traditional Mexican fare. I've also got a Thanksgiving class, Thanksgiving prep, getting ready for the big day, coming up in November. We've also got one generally around once a month, but they have a variety of chefs that teach here as well. Jasper teaches out here.
Awesome.
And some other well-known chefs.
All right, Matt, thank you very much. Oh, by the way, everyone I've interviewed has been following me around all morning. You want to come with us? We're going to the escape room next. Do you want to come with?
Sure, sounds like fun.
All right, let's lock ourselves in an escape room and see if we can get out. That's coming up in about 30 minutes. Until then, Abby, let's head it back to you as we eat these delicious street tacos.
Hey, Matt. Okay, from cooking to crafts, we've got it all here in Lee's Summit, and I am joined by a familiar face, Melissa Winnenberg. Now, you may know her because she decorates our set pretty often at Fox 4 and makes it beautiful, and now you have a new store in downtown Lee's Summit. Tell me about it.
Okay, Ivy and Sparrow is right next to Very Violet. So if you've ever been to Very Violet, just look to the right and we're there. And the reason we're loving it so much is we have a great big area in the back to do workshops. Crafts and florals and all the things.
Okay, so this is super exciting because, first of all, a lot of people, including myself, I don't want the mess at my house. Right. I don't want to do the craft at home. Second of all, I don't do well with crafting, period. Right. I need someone to hold my hand. So tell me about the classes. What can people learn how to do?
Okay, the first one we have coming up, I'm so excited. Belle Fiore Farm and Floral has made these beautiful pumpkin floral arrangements. So we're going to teach everyone how to do that. And the great thing is you just show up and you leave with something amazing like this. You do nothing, no prep, no anything. She does everything for you, teaches you how to do it, and then you can do it again another time.
Right. And that's really nice, too, because part of the battle is buying the things that you think you might need, and then you end up not needing them all.
Right. It's more expensive, I think, to do just one thing like that. Mm-hmm. But if you come to a workshop like this, you get exactly what you need, and you learn a new skill, and you're surrounded by a community of other wonderful people.
Right. Okay, so that's going to be at Ivy and Sparrow, your new store in downtown Lee Summit.
but you can also learn how to make these gorgeous blankets, and we will talk about that later on. But if you want to find out when you can make those, you can go to the website as well. So thank you so much for joining us, Melissa. All right, coming up next, Kathy is in Lee's Summit. And are you hearing the sound of cash registers? Because I certainly am. Kathy is shopping. We're going to find out where coming up.
All right, so I cannot believe that the holidays are almost here. Well, I know they are because here we're at Cameron's. We're taking a look at the latest trend. This is just gorgeous. So, Amy, what is the trend? You say cozy, warm?
Yeah, cozy. We're seeing a lot of people just wanting to hunker down in their homes and cuddle up. So sweaters, birch, fuzzy, everything cozy this year.
And so where we are is the dining room. A lot of people will be spending the time in the dining room. And, of course, Cameron's has been here 19 years. It started because you were in college. Yeah. You said, Dad, I want to start a business. And he said, okay, you go ahead and do it. But you know what? Come on. He had to join in eventually, Steve, didn't you? So when people come in here, you want them to feel as if they're shopping with family.
Correct. I mean, I have my grandkids here today, and I think when people come into the store, they actually feel like they're part of the family when they come in. We have regular customers come in. When the new ones come in, when they're greeted, they feel like they're family. They're relaxed when they come in. So,
well, I mean, you see this Christmas tree. Come on, let's go to the living room. So dining room to the living room. That Christmas tree, it's very soft. It's very warm. And you do. And, I mean, here's the couch. It's the front of the business. Come on, right?
Well, we just want you to come in, come on. Be comfortable, relax. Just feel like you're shopping with friends. I mean, we're right here in downtown.
And you got your candles. Oh, this is cool. Oh, this is interesting for the storage. Yeah. Steve?
What's that?
Grandpa? All right, there we go. Okay, so tell me.
We know you can buy pillows anywhere. You can buy throws anywhere. So we want to take it up one notch. We offer customization. So this is what we call the grandma pillow. This makes an excellent gift. You know, when you're shopping for your mom, yeah, you can put all your grandkids' names on there.
I feel like I'm at home. Let's sit down, guys. This is my new family.
Two of them are on there.
Okay, your names are on there. Okay. Thank you so much for taking me around. Let me shop. All right, we'll take it. I'll take the couch. Oh, I love it. Wait, where's that animal print pillow?
Oh, right,
where's
by
the animal print pillow?
Right by Dad, down there.
Okay,
on the corner.
Grandpa. You got it there?
It
okay.
Let
me just show you. There we go. Ha-ha. There we go. I got it. Back to you in the studio or wherever you are. I don't know. We're in Lee Summit somewhere on Thursday.
All right, Kathy, thanks so much. Coming up next, we are talking about a big rivalry game going on tonight in Lee Summit. We're going to be talking to some of the athletic directors from the high schools, and we're talking to former Chiefs players.
That's right. Bill Moss is here. Bobby Bell. And Neil Smith, I think he's out of... Who?
Danon Hughes.
Danon Hughes is here. All right,
yes.
I didn't get the change of persons.
So we're going to talk to them coming up right after the breaks.
All right, folks, we are talking sports, and sports is big in Lee Summit, is it not?
Yeah!
We've got the volleyball team back here from Lee Summit West, who is... I was at your match a couple of days ago, and you beat Lee Summit North, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yes. Although I love Lee Summit North, that's where my kids went to school. So, but it was all for a good cause, raised a lot of money for breast cancer research. And with us now is Jeremy Hubbard, Lee Summit West Athletic Director. We have Tracy Bertonson, is that how you pronounce it?
Yeah.
With Lee Summit, she's the Athletic Director. And then Jamar Mosey, Lee Summit North Football Coach. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
How's your season this year?
Well, it depends on the day.
Yeah.
We're doing all right. We're 4-2. We're second in our conference. We just played Lee Summit West in a tough, tough game. Kind of came down to the last play. So it doesn't get any easier from here on out. But
and tonight you take on Lee Summit, right?
Take on Lee Summit. So
and who's going to win that game?
Ooh. Well, we'll see.
We'll see. It is a good one thing I like about Lee Summit is right now you got three high schools. I think a fourth is coming, right, eventually? At some point, they're kind of talking about it maybe, but there's so much rivalry among these three high schools. Tell us, Tracy, how do you handle that from a standpoint of the kiddos and having a good friendship rivalry?
Coached and taught and been an administrator in this district for a long time, and I've always felt like playing the crosstown rivals was the toughest game on the schedule, regardless of the talent level or the predicted outcome. So it's an opportunity to teach kids how to behave and to compete in a professional and courteous and sportsmanlike manner. And that's one of the greatest lessons we learn in sports.
Lee Summit West is the newest high school, built, I think, what, 8 years ago, something like
that? 2004, so this is our 16th year.
What?
Yep.
I am getting old.
You blink and it goes quick.
Oh, my goodness. You guys have dealt with a lot of redistricting issues. Some people weren't too happy about that, but It seems like it doesn't matter which high school you go to, you get a good quality education. My kids were ready for college and knocked it out of the park because they had such great teachers at the high school and middle school level.
Yeah. That's what's great about this district. I mean, all the teachers are great. We have great students. It doesn't matter which high school you go to, which middle school you go to, you're getting a great education and you're prepared for life after high school.
Well, thank you so much. The game is tonight at 7, or which field are you playing on?
We're at home.
Oh, at the home. Home of the Broncos. Any Broncos here? Wow. Any Titans here? Yeah! And what's the mascot for West?
Titans.
Oh, all right. What's the Lee Summit?
Tigers.
Tigers. Any Tigers here?
Yeah!
All right. There you go. Our executive producer, were you a Tiger?
My son's.
Oh, your sons are. Okay. All right. Coming up next, you may know a few of these Chiefs players that we're going to be talking with. We have rounded them up, and we're going to find out what's going on in their lives and what they think of the Chiefs this year and what happened last week in our game. Also, still ahead, the four must-sees in Lee Summit, truly yours. Stay with us. Our ship trip, and it is a pandemonium situation here inside the French space. Yes. The tomahawk chop is going on.
Woo!
Woo! All right.
We've got a lot of Chiefs fans in the house today.
We do. It was not a great week last week for Kansas City football, let's face it.
It was a little rough, but you know, now we remember what it's like to lose, I guess.
Yes. we've got some superstars with us here. Bill Moss.
Yes, sir. Woo!
Bobby Bell Jr. Good to see you. And Danon Hughes. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
All right. Woo! Bill, I want to start with you because you're so, you're all immersed in the community here in Lee Summit. How do you go from a professional football career? I know you do commercial real estate. How do you make that transition into something that is lasting and an investment in the community?
I think the big thing is, Mark, is being, you know, entrenched in Kansas City, in the community, in Lee Summit. Came here in 1984 and kept my roots here. By the time I was done, you had so many relationships built that it is just a natural fit. You get to know people, understand what they're doing, transition into some business, and of course, started off eating cinnamon buns down here at Neighbor's Cafe.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's a big part of it.
That'll put some weight on you quick, won't it?
Yes.
So what do you think about this Chiefs team that we're watching right now? I mean, are these guys the real deal?
Absolutely, when healthy. I mean, right now we're like a mash unit. And you're going to have some ups and downs when you got teams that have to go through a lot of injuries like the Chiefs have. Mm-hmm. So fortunately, it's the early part of the season. And, you know, there's a lot of people that jumped off the ship since...
Already?
What?
One game,
back.
Right?
One game.
We played our worst offensive game, our worst defensive game, our worst special teams game, and we still had a chance to win at the end. So there's a lot to still be positive about with this Chiefs team.
Bobby, what's your assessment of this season?
You don't want to go to the bathroom when the offense is on the field. So
true.
You better stick around because you don't want to miss the show.
Good very, deal. Very true.
What are you guys doing now? You've got a business, don't you, Bobby?
Yeah, I have a carpet cleaning company.
Yeah,
here
I thought
town.
So.
Yeah.
I think we've used you in the past.
You have.
Very good company. And what are you doing now, Dan?
I work with U.S. Bank in the home mortgage department. I'm the manager of the Kansas City, Missouri side of the state, so I have all the branches and loan offices that report to me and just creating home loans for people.
Now, if I remember correctly, on our Red Friday show, it was the first time you had ever had a taco.
Yes, and the last.
And the last, okay.
Now, why is that?
I'm just a very picky eater. I'm not a healthy eater, but I'm a picky eater.
You don't like your food mixed?
No.
Yeah, you've got to have
it separate. And what is it? I remember you had, you eat like five things on a regular.
I'm a meat and potatoes guy.
Yeah.
Throwing some chicken.
Uh-huh.
I'm good.
Okay.
Every day, all day.
I like it. Very simple.
I'm a Jersey guy, so I've got to get some pasta, too. So.
Okay.
But Mexican food, I just never had it. Probably won't ever have it again.
Oh, my goodness. Look at what you got. Now, let me tell you, Neil and I go way back, and you got to call Neil a couple of days ahead of time to make sure he's there. Neil is, if you're going to be late for your own funeral.
Absolutely.
All right. But we love you. Neil, I don't think you're mic'd up here. Come over to my mic.
What have you been doing lately?
Well, I'm living it live right now.
Yeah, that's right.
Thanks for catching me on the spare of the moment. But anyway, Mark,
there you go.
I'm here.
You are. you got your knee replaced a couple of years ago, didn't you?
No, I actually had hip replacement.
Hip replacement.
And then I had a L3, 4, and 5 fusion.
You seem to be doing pretty good.
I'm doing a lot better now.
You know, Deron just had his knee replaced.
Right. I know. I heard about that.
A lot of wear and tear.
A lot of wear and tear in the NFL.
And then my head is starting to hurt a little bit, so that's coming next, right?
I wonder what's causing that. How's your golf game?
Fair.
Fair, all right.
Fairly, yeah.
Neil and I played.
It's like the weather night. It's like the weather outside right now.
Yeah. You're one heck of a putter, too.
Thank you, sir.
Got it. Your drive's not bad.
Is that a nice way of saying the rest of his game?
Well, it's all right.
He can hit the ball, let me tell you. But thank you, all you guys, what you do in our community.
Thank you.
And we appreciate you being here.
Great being part of Lee Summit.
Yes, all right. Hey, coming up. We've got the four must-sees here in Lee Summit. If you've never been here, four things you must see when you come.
Carly, thanks. Hey, there are great places to go to Lee Summit, but Matt had the hard job of narrowing it down to just four, and he's at the number one right now.
All right, let's get to him, Matt.
Good morning. Yeah, the number one rated attraction here in Lee Summit is the exit room, and we are locked inside. Kind of a creepy one, right? Some spiders. Well, with Halloween, I guess. And look who's here to help me, okay? I have Matt and Jennifer for a Time From Anything, and I have, of course, Candace from the Whistle Stop. She's been with me since 7:15 this morning. She can't get enough of us. We're going to try to figure out how to get out of this exit room while you watch four other things you must see if you come here to Lee Summit. Our first must-see in Lee Summit is this parking lot at 2nd and Douglas. Okay, it doesn't look like much, but on Wednesdays and Saturdays, this place transforms into one of the best farmers markets in the entire state of Missouri.
More than 50 vendors grow and sell their fresh fruits and vegetables here. Named Missouri's favorite farmers market 7 years in a row by American Farmland Trust, the Lee Summit Farmers Market closes at the end of November, so go now to see what all the hype is about.
Did you know that Lee Summit is home to the world's most beautiful farm? And this place is huge! The Longview Mansion, built more than 100 years ago.
Owned by R.A. Long, the Kansas City lumber baron and philanthropist, he gave this estate to his daughter Lula, a champion horse rider. Built in 1913, this mansion was one of 50 structures on the land. There was also a horse track, a police and fire station, a newspaper, and a church. More than 200 people worked here at one time. Over the years, much of the land was sold to the county to build Longview Lake and Longview College. New owners recently spent $3.5 million renovating this mansion. And while they book a lot of weddings, you can also take a tour or go to a shopping event or a murder mystery.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Murder mystery shows selling at Longview Mansion.
Go to longviewmansion.com to learn more.
And if you love the outdoors, you should visit Lake Jacoma, where they have a native hoofed animal enclosure, which include elk and bison.
Built back in the 1970s, this fenced-in area features close to 30 elk and 30 bison on 110 acres of land. It's free to visit, but don't feed them. Nearby is Missouri Town 1855. This is a great place to take the family to learn what life was like on the prairie during the 1800s. Reenactors dress in period clothing and explain the hardships the pioneers faced as they settled the Lee Summit area.
And our number one must-see here in Lee Summit is Paradise Park. For more than 30 years, they've been entertaining kids with so many things to do, including riding the go-karts, batting cages, and mini-golf.
This is an entertainment paradise for families with video games, rock walls, escape rooms, laser tag, a foam factory, and bumper cars. But families with young children love the sensory play area, where kids can go to different themed rooms and learn new things through touch, taste, sight, and smell. With so much to do here, it's a great way to keep the kids entertained whenever you visit Lee Summit.
And thank goodness I was able to escape that escape room in like record time. No thanks to my friends. Look, they're still stuck in there. We are backstage. You can kind of see all the security cameras in all these exit rooms. This is where they kind of monitor the situation, make sure that they don't get too stuck inside. But we have Greg Arbuckle. He is the owner of the Exit Room. You have five different exit rooms here. And how much fun is it for you to watch people kind of get lost inside them?
It's amazing. I mean, it really is. It's the funnest business that you could ever own. You see people working, you know, teamwork together. We've seen things that we can't even explain on TV. So you see some pretty amazing stuff.
All right, let's let Eli get past us so he can kind of show folks at home what this place looks like. You guys have really expanded and exploded. What do you think is going on? The escape room just seems to be really popular right now.
For me, honestly, and the fun part of owning the business is we're in such a digital world, and I am too. I'm a techie, but for 60 minutes, we offer groups the opportunity to actually do something live. So groups of eight people interacting together, phones are down, and they're working together in the real world. It's not the phone, and oftentimes we'll have teenage kids that forget leave their phones here and have to come back and get them, which is like the world's greatest compliment, right?
Well, and finally, Greg, why did you decide to open up in downtown Lee's Summit?
It's just wonderful here. We are within walking distance of every shop, every restaurant, every bar that you featured today. And so people will come here, they do the, you know, the 60-minute adventure, and then they walk and they just stay here in downtown Lee's Summit for the whole evening.
So much fun. And by the way, this is surgery. Mark Alford and his family did this escape room, and I am told that his whole family escaped, but he didn't. I think they lobotomized him or something. That explains a lot, actually. But it's so much fun out here at the exit room, and oh, good. Hey, you finally made it out. Oh, I was so worried about you guys. Goodness gracious. So this is just one of many fun things to do here in Lee's Summit. It's been a great time on this Zip Trip, getting to learn this city and all the things that you can do if you come here to downtown Lee's Summit. Matt Stewart, Fox 4 News.
It is fun, and we got even more importantly, we didn't kill each other, cramped in that one room.
You learn a lot about people in that 45-minute time span.
Don't eat beans before you go.
Good advice.
Hey, we have had like 23 total Zip Trips. 12 of those have been the big Zip Trips where we've gone to towns. Our last one is today in Lee's Summit. We're going to do it again next year.
Oh, it's so much fun.
But I want you to meet a guy who has been at every big Zip Trip we've been at starting this spring. His name's Doc Morey, and he is a personal friend of mine who we got to be friends. I think we met at the Jazz Fest when we used to do that Corporate Woods, didn't we?
You pulled me out of the gutter that night. Yes.
Yeah. Doc has an interesting history. He's a great guy in his own right, but your uncle was?
It was Walter, and I grew up with Uncle Walter and Aunt Betsy, and it gave me a tremendous perspective.
In fact, he's buried at Mount Moriah, and I see you out there every Memorial Day paying honor to, he was a big hero of mine, and you have the coolest car, his Triumph, that you have restored in British Racing Green.
And there's a fun story behind that. He got me interested in sports cars when I was a kid visiting. He used to race them. And then when I was in college, I worked for a dealership that sold Triumphs, and I introduced him to Triumphs. Well, he went back to New York and bought a TR6 and told Aunt Betsy, he said, "Well, Betsy, old girl, I've got us a beautiful sports car, and it's a fast Triumph, and it's beautiful British Racing Green." The problem was Walter Cronkite was colorblind and the car was brown.
Oh, no.
So,
no way.
So he knew that I liked the car and I was going to restore one. So when he passed away, he willed it to me. And as a tribute to him, I had it painted British Racing Green.
It is awesome. I wish I had been in I've ridden in it. It is a gorgeous car. I wish I had forwarded a picture. But I'll put it up on my Facebook page so you can all see it.
Well, that'd be terrific. A nice tribute to him. And it's fun to drive around. I don't get in and out of it as easy as I did when I was 20. But
none of
expect?
Us do.
What
it's
do
all
you expect?
And I just want to close our interview by saying, and that's the way it is.
Well done, sir. Well done.
All right. Thank you, Doc, for being my friend and a friend of Fox 4 and for being so loyal coming to every Zip Trip that we've had.
A lot of fun having you along with us.
Thank you for being you two.
Well, that
just
is very
a ray of sunshine on Fridays.
Aww. That is so nice.
Thank you so much.
All right, I don't know how we can beat that, but coming up next, we've got the best moments from our Zip Trips over the summer, so stick around. You're not going to want to miss it. I love this
place! It's a party in the OP!
And they are
so good. These are young people.
Oh, are we back?
And he is stepping out of the Ford, Olathe Ford RV right now.
There he is.
Coming up. I like kind of going around in circles. I do that a lot in
you
life.
You do that. Yeah. I think you do.
We will see you later. Kansas City, you like that? Well, there's a place here in town that turns belts into earrings. Does that look good?
No. All right, this is
Kathy's.
Our giant turkey legs, tender.
Ooh. Take a bite out of that,
okay, Kathy. Well, I don't want to do that on TV.
You look like you're laying at the Renaissance Festival.
The rooster showing contest. Tell me about that, because I think Mark Offer would be great as a competitor or as a sponsor.
All right, we have some people that we need to thank here today. Fred Leggett with Lee Summit Tribune, Donnie Rogers with Downtown Lee Summit, Cheryl Nash with City of Lee Summit.
Yeah, we've got Summit Video. We have so many guests here. We want to thank all of you. Behind the scenes too.
It is incredible. Yeah. Our engineer staff is unbelievable.
Yeah. Yes.
Our producers. Yeah. I want to say a special thanks to Dana McDaniel, our former news director, who's now in San Diego. This was kind of her idea, mm-hmm. but everyone got it in line with it and go, yes!
Yeah.
And so it's been a lot of fun doing
this. Lots of hours by all of our producers and our web team. So thank you to everybody at Fox 4.